I'm here and I'm just going to give you some tips on harvesting your produce from the seeds that you got from the seed library. We're going to start with some winter squash. This is a ripe winter squash. And you'll see as they're flowering, they have beautiful yellow flowers. And then they'll slowly ripen from more of a white squash into this beautiful orange color. When the stem starts to dry and get brittle, and when this color, when it's orange like this one is, it's ready to harvest. Another way to check is to use the side of your nail and just take a little bit of the skin off near the top of the squash. If it's green underneath, it's not ready yet. But this one here today is ready. So we're going to go ahead and trim the stem near the vine. And bring it in the house. So green beans have these beautiful white flowers that we can see here, and they actually attract a ton of pollinators as well. So we really love these, and they're so nutritious for us. So you can see these are tiny baby beans growing, and they'll slowly grow and get bigger and bigger. And if we look inside our leaves, we can see some beans that are ready to harvest. So they'll start small and really skinny, and as they grow, they'll kind of fatten out, and you'll be able to see the seed lumps. These are little lumps of seed inside. Once you can start to see individual seed lumps, they're ready to harvest. So go ahead, without disturbing the flowers around it, and with your nail or a sharp tool, a clean, sharp harvesting tool, go ahead and harvest your beans. Okra is another one of those that will produce consistently over the summer, and it has these beautiful yellow flowers. Sometimes they're red or a variety of colors, and okra is part of the hibiscus family. Can you see the similarities in this flower versus a hibiscus flower? Excellent. So okra will start as a flower like this and then get these little small pods and slowly grow into a bigger okra. Once they're about finger length or a little longer, oh, look at that bee. We can go ahead and harvest them, and you want to just cut about halfway down the stem with a clean harvesting tool, and you have an okra. Now, okra is really awesome because it will produce very quickly as well, so make sure you're harvesting every other day to make sure you're getting the most tender baby okra. And we'll keep going. Tomatoes generally have these really cute little yellow flowers, and this one isn't flowering right now, but they are also continual flowers, so they will produce a lot over the course of the summer. Anyway, they'll slowly grow from these tiny little baby green guys into something a little bit bigger, and then start to turn red or yellow. There are orange tomatoes, there are purple tomatoes, there are striped tomatoes. It's really fun fact. You can harvest them when they're about halfway ripe and then finish ripening on a windowsill or in a sunny spot. That will help ensure that they don't get eaten by something else before you're able to bring them in the house. So these two right here are definitely ready to do that. If you want to let them go and get this beautiful, brilliant red color on the vine, that's great too. Just go ahead and harvest them in the same way that we've been harvesting a lot of things today. Take something sharp and trim about halfway up the stem. Be careful not to damage the main plant, because that will continue to grow. And cucumbers also come in a variety of different shapes and sizes. Some are very tiny and skinny, and they'll be ready much sooner than the larger varieties like this one. So cucumbers, you can tell when they're ready when they start to get a little bit yellow at the end and when they get pretty big. Now, you can also harvest them when they're teeny tiny, especially if you're going to make baby pickles. These are delicious. But usually we like to eat cucumbers, so we're going to go ahead and harvest them when they're this size or even a little bit smaller. This one's starting to get overripe just because of how white it is, and we don't want it to have a bitter skin. So again, with our little harvesting tool, we're just going to trim the stem, careful to not damage the main plant or the main vine. All right, so the last thing I want to talk to you all about today is melon. I'm not sure if this is a honeydew or a muskmelon or a cantaloupe. But a lot of them are the signs for harvest are really similar in all of them. This one's still very green, but you can see it's starting to get the textured pattern on the outside, and it's starting to turn a little bit brown on that texture. When the actual rind starts to turn brown, the stem will also get a little bit brittle. And that's how you know they're going to be sweet and delicious. So you're going to go ahead and harvest the same way we harvest everything, with a sharp tool, and trim the stem, careful not to harm the main plants. Thanks everyone for harvesting with me today. We have a beautiful basket of produce here. I hope you've had as much success with your seeds as we have here. Go ahead and let us know how you're doing. You can reach out in the comments of this video.